have to keep moving. Go back to our system here, and let's just log in and see what where we are, where we stand. Oh, would be nice if I can XP. Damn. Okay. Let's see what we have today. So let's say 11:44. Right, telepathy is as was right, was going the right way. Data and T, I see. So let's do these two first. Telepathy, data, home. And this is apprentice phase. So we have there. So I'll just create at that like that. And then just that should take care of that. Then we also have that context data home. Context data home T. And let's do this here. And this is right create on the file, actually on the file, so this should basically be added. Alright, then let's just go on top and just work through our way. This is abort, A-B-R-T, Apple. And then it's for cash. I'll just add that here. Oh, that's cash. Oh, data on to you. Data on to you, yeah. So it's good attribute. Data on the Canberra. Cash on the and data on the right here. Get it with the search. Canberra, then we have UNESCO mom DNSSEC mom. Get attribute and search, get attribute search, and then also change this here. Just leave this default IP. So get attributes. All right. And then we have this, but we already, so we need to review this later. Evo alarm. Evo alarm. Get attribute and search. Delph. Still in the factory. This also should be loud. Evo Gal factory. Evo Gal. And then Deacon should be. See, if you want to get to data home tree, then you'll have to go through Deacon home tree first. Okay, and here we have a Evo source registry. Evo source reg. So I think it's probably going to traverse. Yeah, it's obviously going to traverse. Because it's here, it's creating something. This we have already. Then we have Mampion Diamond. Then we have G Session. What's this session doing? Yeah. It's move 9. That makes sense. This session remove 9, yeah. And then data and t-search. And the other stuff, we'll ignore that for now. Here we have data converts. Data convert GSET. GSET data convert. GNOME shell. Makes sense. If you want to get to data home tree, you've got to go through Deacon home first. Network manager applet. But then you'll have to get to Qigong first. As the applet. Same thing. This is the user itself, also getting bigger and bigger every time. This we took care of. This we need to take care of. So let's just have a look at that home tree. And then grab create. And then just have a look at LS all home login, my login user, my login user, local. What we got here, so we have telepathy properly labeled, we have contacts properly labeled. And we can work on tracker. So let's work on tracker first, and we have evolution finally. So now let's just work on evolution first. Evolution source registry. And I already added that, didn't I? Because yeah, evolution. Yeah, I did. So, where is evolution cache empty? And the source reg. Yeah. So, I was right after all. We get the same idea. Of course, yeah, this also needs a search, obviously. And so does this. Data, and we'll just keep it on right for now. Okay, and data. Data. have a look. Here, I have Tracker, which is done by Tracker Store. So let's see, TR store cash on to. I might get a cash back on to. Same idea. Different type, and then here we have this one. It's Gconf Hunty, Gconf Hunty, and then just copy this over. Then it's basically right name. Can remove this one, and then we have this dir add name, and then I'll just create, let's just create get attributes and search, and this is data. Data empty. Let's take care of that. What else do we have? GNOME shell created by GNOME shell. So shell data on t, now go to GNOME shell and just add that in. So where are my declarations? So I'll just put them here. Type g shell data home t type attribute g shell data home t, and that's basically a file type, but it's also a that, but it was small, wasn't it? Well, I don't use home type, file type. I guess this is it. Okay, so let's just add that in. Let's see where we have. So here we have it actually traversing. So let's add type at type transition here. type position, GNOME shell, data empty, and this is there, and we're going from data empty to G shell data empty. But we're only going to do this on GNOME shell directories. Alright. Now we need to basically write and add a name to the data allow, and then I'll just paste that in. And then it's G shell data home T dir, and I'll just add create get attribute search, because yeah, it creates it, but it's probably going to create something in there as well, so that should probably be reasonable. What else do we have? ICC. And ICC currently has a type, because ICC data home key. See? ICC data home key. So we need to basically use that. Who creates it? ICC there. It's created by GNOME settings daemon. So we need to go to GNOME settings daemon. Go all the way up. And this require the type. I'll just require it, require, because it's already there, type. And then just basically here where it's right, add name, the same, it's the same story all over again, type transition. And then it's my login user gset, and then it's this data home t dir, and then it's this type. And this is only for the ICC directory. So basically now we can just allow my login user gset, and then it's ICC data home key, and it's there. I will just say create get attribute and search for now. Give it some basics. Let's see what else do we have. So we have this G settings data convert. Now, so we need to add that G settings data convert. So we, let's just start by the beginning. So we have home dir. Then it's local share, and then it's basically, but we're going to do this, and it's a single file, and then just copy, and I'll just call this data convert. This is just a file, just so you know, and we cannot use name type transitions. So gset data convert, have concert. I keep typing concert. So let's add a new type. Type. That, and I'll have this in my buffer. And this is a file type and a user home type. And then just make that happen. So we can do a name file transition. So we already know. So let's just first do this. Type transition, and then it's my login user g set data convert t paste, and then it's basically data home t, and then it's file actually. And then it's this type. And then basically we can put this over a couple of times. Basically this is a write and an add name for data home tier. And then here we have that data convert data home tier data convert data home t. This is file. This create getting created. So I'll just do get attribute and create. I'm sorry about my cough. Sincerely. It's my health. It's you don't wanna know. So we have this is basically it. So let's just build this. We have some errors here. ICC data home t. Yeah. So ICC data. Oh. ICC data. Let's fix the typos first. Because, you know, there's always a typo here. Type attribute at line. So I'll just. I'm sorry about the cough. Probably resonating through the speakers. I talk too much, and especially now, but I'm doing like 5-6 hours a day doing these screencasts. So, yeah. So let's kill them all, and then just clear, and then do that ls temp and put temp again. Not sure why I'm even doing this, but just have it. RM RF temp Okay, let's do an out search. MHDTS 1213. Audit to allow. And unless that. Somehow, the shit got misinterpreted. Still have to do with period conf. Still have a long ways to go. And I'm the wrong type. Password, of course. Always the same. So we at 12:15 right now. Slowly but surely, progressing. See, I see some stuff that I can already be added quite simply. Like for example that Evo Address Factory. Managing some content in Evolution Data Home Dirs. Let's just look that up. Okay, then we have dconf, we have Evo Alarm messing with dconf. This is a Fanta. You're right in that name. Basically, everyone should basically be allowed stuff like that. But oh yeah, and this data on TV, I then oh. Damn. Then you also have to go to Gcon. So that's that, and then we have Evo Cal Factory getting an attribute of evolution data. Evo Cal Factory. Now, I'm pretty certain that it's going to want to search it as well. PDF Evo source registry. Evo source reg. And let's just for now paste it in there. So it's there. Let's see. So it's probably creating something in there as well, or either another there or so we have no keyring diamonds. And this one here. Dset data convert. Where is dset data convert? And let's just paste it in here for a second and see what it is. Data home T, it wants to actually also be able to remove it. And then it's creating a file, yeah, I know that, and that file. It's renaming it. That's why we didn't use the name file transition, because basically what it does, it creates it with a random prefix and then later renames it. For some reason, that's the way they do it. Alright, so now we're not done yet. We have ICC stuff for dset daemon. So, dset is probably somewhere up here. So let's move this here for a while. Let's see, it's adding stuff to the door. And then it's basically creating a file in there. Also does some other stuff. Basically creates a file in data, in the data home there, and I don't know what that is yet. And here we have login user. We have TR store doing stuff. TR store. TR store, and it's data. So it's here, and I'll just add it for a while here. And so it's just adding, it's adding stuff. A file. So it's putting a file in there. And then remove this stuff. So now we have all that. Let's just have a look at the creates again. Grab create, see if you can find anything useful. User home to dconf. That's in conf. Tracker, user home to, that's probably also in conf. DNS set trigger creates IEBUS in user home to self-sub conf. This is taken care of. Decon service creates a file that's also in conf probably. Abort also in conf. Testing writability was probably also in conf. User deconf temp td, we took care of that. System data home t, evolution data home t, we took care of that. This also took care. Evolution user home t, this is in conf. This is in conf. Primary, that is that Kerberos thing. Ops. Probably in conf, so we need to take care of that first. So there's just not much we can do. We need to investigate something because if you look. Currently, so config is created, something is allowed to create user home content. And it's one of the things that basically, let's have a look at local though. Local. How far we are there? We're not there yet. Sure. But we're getting close. GNOME settings daemon is basically. And keyrings. So I'm pretty sure that keyrings is. Let's see if we can basically grab it. Grab key rings. So let's just assume that GNOME keyring daemon actually creates key rings. Let's just match path gone. So we need to use this type. So let's just do some assuming. So it's let's just oops. No, don't save. Key rings. Because you gotta play nice with Fedora, so we'll just use Fedora stack. And then just save that, and then go to this, and then put in keyring daemon. It's all the way on top first. So let's create a type, require the type. I'll just require it. This is a user home type, by the way, but I'll just require this one first. User temp type. And it's a temp file. So we require the type, so let's just set up a transition there. We have deconfirm key local. This needs to actually we'll keep it this way. Okay. Well, it also needs to get attribute a search, because else it can never get to a data home key. So now type transition my login user gkrdt. And then it's basically data home t and enter dir, and the dir is type and the name is key rings. Right, allow my login user gkrdt, and then it's that super type, and then that's dir, and then we'll create that dir and we'll get attribute and search it. And then basically with regard to data home dir, we can also allow right at that should take care of key rings. If that's actually what it is. And let's just also make an assumption about GNOME settings daemon. Let's just assume that GNOME settings daemon creates that. So why I'm doing it this way, but I guess it's just the way it is. And then dset data home key, dset the data home key. So I'll just remember this name. Then go to gset d and then just add a type here somewhere, type, and then basically use our own type, and then just basically add that to type transition there. So that's the same deal. And then it's actually creating it. And then I type. And it's called, you know, settings daemon, I think it was. Let's just verify that. Oh, I can't. Oh yeah, I can. It's GNOME settings daemon, yeah. So now basically allow my login user gsetdt, and then it's gsetdt data home to dir create get attributes and search, and then as for data home key, we already have the proper permissions, so it's creating different directories there. See if this builds. Of course it doesn't. So the temp file is not high enough. So I need to once again. That's weird. With types it's not a problem if you require it below where you use it, but when it comes to attributes, so many errors. Damn. Same, this is same. Sorry. Temp type at this point just not declared. You see that I kind of know the ins and outs, so others would probably have a hard time finding why these types aren't found and stuff like that, and I just know that there's some quirks in the compiler, and then I just basically can figure out easily what might be the issue. Kind of there are quirks in this compiler, but once you know them then and you know how to deal with them, then generally it's not a problem. There are still issues that really suck. Oh yeah, and attempt this ESD, these ESD sockets. Either it's not created yet, or That's not too much, but let's just add that, this one. TR store. Remove name from the deur. And unlink the file. And surely but sure, surely we're getting closer and closer. And then at some point we really need to figure out what's wrong with that conf stuff. With that period conf, and also in temp, there's also some magic going on, I think. Not sure. Oh, we need to last this. We need to last this. Oh, and by the way, let's just. So big 40. All right. See, we fixed that GNOME keyring. We made a right assumption there. Sometimes assuming helps. This can be removed, and this is there. Sometimes assuming helps, but it can also be dangerous. He said data empty was also a proper assumption. Data home, it actually reads it, it lists it. And this is there. And as for gset, it actually creates a file in there. So that's intuition. And also that common sense. There says GNOME settings daemon, so yeah, you can assume that if you have a GNOME settings daemon process, that that is what creates it. Looking good. Now we're still with these generic types left. Let's have a look. Just get keep motivated. My login user, local. Share. To stay motivated, sometimes you need to see the improvements. And then also the basic home directory. So the idea is here that these desktop documents, downloads, music, those need to be generic types. That's the idea. But cache, config, etc., etc., these need to be private types. So we really need to deal with config, and that's basically what we need to do now. And basically there is an easy way to do that. Oh, an easy way. There is a way to do that. It's basically to audit who creates it. So we can use the audit allow access factor and then basically reproduce. And it's a long way, but I just think that's a good idea to just do that. And also with regard to that cache there, that's also weird. So I'm going to add some rules now to the policy that just take care of troubleshooting. At least should take care of troubleshooting. So yeah, it sucks, but gotta do it. So all the no, not all the way on top. Let's all the way below. I'll just add two rules. Audit allow domain user home t dir create, but I also do that for data home t, so that or for cache home t, so to see what creates cache home t. So add that rule, build it. Solid. See what's happening there, because something really strange is happening there. I mean, my login user with the system U identity, that makes sense. I think someone is using Chicken or something. That makes sense. Someone's trying to be smart. Someone is trying to be smart. But it's really not smart, in my view. Okay, login. And I'll just grab for grants. I'll be damned. So XDM is actually creating it. Can you believe that? But still not config, no config. So weird. That's just so weird. Something's creating it, or am I just not deleting it? Nano clear. Weird. That's strange, buddies. That's weird. But I already said that 6-7 times. Doom shell. A network manager applet. Basically, they all need to be able to do this. So I'm actually going to do that, because it's obvious by now. So, decon. Temp T there. I'll just do it in 2 runs. Because they all need it. It's just whoever comes first, first serve, first come, first serve basis. all need to be able to, some light, they all need to be able to create that. Whoever gets there first gets to create it. So I'll just add a right add name. Actually, I also need a link. Then also a remove name. Well, actually, only hit this one. The others shouldn't remove it. So if you basically, you can basically create a template for GNOME components and then allow these rules that apply to all GNOME components. I think I got them all right now. Yeah, I probably have them all right now. Yeah. So I still haven't figured out what the heck is going on. So the configdir is not created by XDM. It's just not, because if it was, then it would have been created with the system user. But how come it end up with the wrong type? So let's have a look at my main system LSR. Oh, actually, can just grab config, and it's created here properly. And if I match path condo. Restored. So what's going on? Yeah. It's not created with the user home T type, but it's there with the user home T type. It's not created by XDM because, or it seems to be not created by XDM because it has its system UI doesn't have system UI identity. So then let's just then that just makes me wonder what's going on in there. And the same goes for that. Config home T. I'll just make expand this a little bit. Relabel to, and then require type config home T, because I really want to know what's going on. And it's not telling me anything. Then we're still, so I have this stuff in temp, which that makes sense. You see, oh right, does make sense. Nice. It does make sense. It's created with the tools audio temp type, so no need to worry. Let's log out. We're just the only thing we're dealing with is run user and config. We have this Kerberos thing. Going on that 1303. Let's do that first. Looking good. We have this Kerberos thing going on. Let's just list. See, the config there is actually gone. So it is created. Just don't know who creates it. So let's try this again. Never seen this before. did install. If that makes sense. It just doesn't make sense. Okay, let's just assume, because we have very little other choice. Let's assume that G-Session creates it. We have very little other choice at the moment. Require type. Config home t. And then type transition. My login user G session. T user home der T der config home T. And then that's for config. Then allow my login user G session T config home T and then dir and then create get attribute search. I'm at the moment just totally clueless right here. dog out. Should be taking a break soon. And it seems that TDM agrees. But it's kind of addictive, this work. It's repetitive, but it's also nice. Nope. Fuck. Nope, it's not GNOME Session doing this. I'll be damned. Also still don't see what creates. That Kerberos thing. Actually, that's created by TDM as well. System view. So, I'm going to clean this up for now. Not GNOME Session, I'm afraid to say. What it is, I don't know, but it's not that. At least at this point, I really don't know. Anything. At this point, I really don't know anything. So, breaky time. We'll finish this later.